The first time when I went last year, I didn't know anything about the village. I was exploring it, as with every new day. It was hard this time around. Part of me wanted to understand what was happening. Why was poverty such a deeply rooted, entrenched existence for them?
Hello, chef. I to Kuijiu, how much do I need to pay? 15.
15? 15.
Okay.
大概需要多长时间你到你的？我们走路就是两个小时。啊，你走路的时候累不累？不累。我也觉得，如果我走了两个小时，累死了。当这条路修好之后，然后我就把。
They're having a meeting upstairs, the poverty alleviation officials, and I'm gonna join them to see what they're talking about.
I do feel that the pressure is on these people right now because the deadline is approaching. It's the end of 2020 and they have to help everyone shake off poverty and get over the line of poverty before the end of this year. So that leaves us with 3 months.
这几天重点工作没什么，但是像这些发放贷款，还有这些琐事比较多。对。这个我们那个解决的，医院解决的，咱们在这儿，先把这些群众给拉了。So
these are the medical fees of the villagers here from last year. So for example, this person went to hospital in February. Last year, the total medical bills were 6,405 yuan, of which they paid 313, 5% of the total medical bills. A lot more paperwork for them to fill.
Thank you.
我们这里上次带你过来的时候，我问你这里房子漂亮吗？对，我说还行。还行。对。但是现在再看呢？对，现在我觉得偏漂亮，比他们的以前的房子。他们以前的房子肯定跟这里没法比。对。因为这个房子修好之后，对，它存在一些很多各种各样的问题。呀。比如像。 他们一些门窗坏了的，现在再给他们修补一下。哎呦，你还记得他吗？对，奶奶哈耀，就是住在我们村委会下面的那一个，对不对？当你做了什么事呢？这样讲，孩子又要好，你们也要好。
新的房子怎么样？新，八十平，八十，那个床几点是贵，但是公馆沙发，啥子都是，优惠，八十就是新房子屋，屋热，娃娃三个，哦，好的很。Even within less than a year period, for me was an astonishing achievement, building houses, finishing building houses, connecting them to a grid, electricity grid. And this year, I think it was either in June, late June, early July, that the villagers had moved to these new houses.
县、州、省、国家，它都要有一个脱贫的程序，我们只是现在还在走程序，没走完。
不是，如果抛开这个程序说的话，我们村现在已经是所有农户都达到脱贫的标准了。从你上一次过来到现在，他们的变化是非常大的。
对，
从房子到环境卫生，到破路，对，到公路，
对，新公路。
所以这些都是这个地方的进步。你晚上好好休息一下，休息一下，我们明天继续。对，现在需要的就是好好休息。对。你好。
你好。
身体好不好？
还好，还好，你呢？怎么样？还好。这是所有的沙发、家具、茶几、电视。他们自己买还是？捐赠的，就是你看，这里有的嘛。啊，对，哦
，OK。这儿有。前几天有没有水？
今天一天一天嘛，来天天就过来了。意思是这几天没有水，是不是？是。哦。OK。这几天估计管道问题。应该有问题。你搞卫生的时候，把厕所弄干净。好。这个你用那个刷子刷干净。好。母亲呢？先哪边了吧？这里。
This time around, Muti's story started well before I could lay my eyes on Muti. Muti starting a new class, Shenroy wanted to take me to show me Muti.
Muti,
you
His last report, he scored 8 in total on all subjects. That's 8 over 300. So obviously there's a problem, but whose problem is it? That's the question. For a few days, we tried to locate him. At one point, we had a tip-off from one of the neighbors that he might be taking a nap in the old house.
He's not here. We were misguided.
Because of lack of staff, we are fixing the water pipes ourselves. I've never been a handyman myself, but there's always a first time for everything. So let's see how the day goes. Okay. Jackpot. We found it. He insisted on running. And now I'm out of breath.
This is a
They're saying that the water has come, but so far there's nothing. I can't hear anything through the pipes.
But they're pretty sure that it's here.
No.
There's so much tension. Everyone's waiting. Everyone needs that water to come. But the question is, will it come? Shanrui.
结束了
外面还有
You don't need to like kill him.
你不行啊，把表全了你们，你要穿一个裤子，你们怎么扔？不能打，没有用。他也不懂事啊，他也不懂事，你不能打。不是打算抓我？那是你自己。把表全了你们，敲嘞。你不行啊，他也不懂事啊，他也不懂事，你不能打。不是打算抓我？那是你自己。哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎，哎， 他的妈妈和他的爸爸打他是为了给另外一家人一个交代，懂吗？这个就是说我的孩子打了你的孩子，这个如果我不打我的孩子，是不是我就在，我没办法跟人家。这个我理解，但是不对，这个不对，不可以那么重大，这么小的孩子。
是啊。
You know, now they have new houses, now they have the road, they have schools, a kindergarten. So the world around them is changing, is modernizing. At one point, the old habits needs to be reconsidered.
So他要去外面打工。对，他说他要去新疆。但是他已经毕业了。他已经毕业了，虽然上面写的他还没到16岁嘛，但是已经有毕业证了，相当于他已经完成那个9年义务教育了，然后他就。 可以遵照他自己的意愿，可以继续读，也可以不读了。然后他现在想去打工的话，我们可以给他开证明了。在新疆做什么？做辣椒。嗯。摘辣椒。嗯。这个就是他妈妈了。嗯。Her
mom is 2 years older than I am. And to think that she already has a 16-year-old daughter with whom she's going to go for work outside is just interesting to say the least. Her mom was 16 years old when she got her. Her daughter is the same age, and again, she's allowing her to make the same decision of just sentencing herself to a life of hardship by starting to pick peppers at 16 years old. And the whole point of that project is to just take that cycle and rip it apart, because enough is enough, because they've lived in poverty for so many years, for decades.
，你知道这个不？工作的办公室。我在这里工作。我办公室没钱吗？想不想去？想。看了以后很想去，没看不想去。
这个是在北京，是故宫。
故宫，这个是故宫。
皇帝的房子。对。Smart.
He really is smart. 你不想去北京？想。对，北京。对。这个是天安门。天安门。对，天安门。
太阳，这个呢？地球。太阳大，地球小。对。来，我准备让你倒了啊！来，你倒，别，我不行，别倒。
Now we have to deal with business. Here he is.
他说他在家里洗衣服，洗衣服啊，是吧？非常不错。但是我今天我跑到老房子去找你，没有人，没看见你。然后是不是？他在洗房子吧？啊，星期五的时候我去找你，你是不是没在学校？你去哪里了？ 他们说你吃了午饭之后，你就不在了。你知道你我主要是想告诉你一声说，你们马上就要读初中了，你一定不要再跑了，知道吗？你得就是顺顺利利的，然后你们整体从小学转移到初中，然后在初中报上名，继续读初中，好不好？The
poverty alleviation team, Shen Rui, has spoken over and over again to them. About the importance of going to school, of not skipping class, of trying to aim high. But I feel that some of these kids at home, they don't get enough support from their parents. Their parents don't follow up closely on their education. They don't sit down with them to do the homework. They don't prep them well to go to school. And everything starts from home. So, if they don't go to school, if their parents don't encourage them, it's going to be really hard to have for them to have a bright future, and that's something that genuinely worries me. And I don't know, I really wish them the best, and yeah, I don't know.
There are things that just don't happen overnight. That comes not on a material level. This is on something much more deeper than that. It's a matter of a state of mind. It's a matter of changing a person's perspective about some things in life. And that obviously doesn't happen overnight.
<音>在里面住了，在这里有几个户？这边有23个，23户人。23啊，对。然后我们这边三组就总共有50套房子，这是三组一号点。嗯。你好，<笑>你怎么从那里下来啊？他说从那里下车。那个背书包那个是我们这三组的村民，叫的是王贵。
他在外面读书，然后今天周五了，他正好回来。这是我朋友。你好。这他是哪里的？他是拉萨的。拉萨乡的。哦，拉萨乡的。你怎么你们两个都会着吉他？你们要学的吉他吗？
对，学吉他。很喜欢吉他，然后就在学校有时间了就唱唱歌。两个芒果。
我想当一名歌手。
嗯。
然后去参加那些什么红豆，唱歌呀、表演什么，我都喜欢。
嗯。
然后毕业以后我自己是想考一个音乐学院的。
你现在为什么读书？因为我看在村里面有很多男孩子跟你一样，他们现在逃课，他们打工，他们不愿意读书。
因为我的梦想。
嗯。
梦想不读书不能实现。
嗯。
所以我也很想读书，因为我以后不想像我那些父母一样在这里劳动怎么怎么的。
嗯。
所以我想读书，读书改变命运嘛。
嗯。
对。
你妈妈和爸爸觉得教育有什么好处？他们支持你读书，还是他们告诉你你需要打工，你需要赚钱什么的？
他们很支持我的，他们不让我去打工。
嗯。
他们说不管怎么样你还是读书出来。
嗯。
考不到大学也好，考不到也好，读书是最好的办法。因为我们农村的这些孩子都不喜欢学习。
对。
为什么呢？因为前辈有些人前面去打工了，然后打工回来以后衣服穿得好好的，皮肤白白的，他们就羡慕，然后给他们买糖吃，他们就很喜欢去打工，去见识一下打工是怎么样的。但是
对，
实际上打工是很不好的。
嗯，
我觉得不管怎么样，在哪里都还是学习好，学习好了以后嘛，去哪里都是有的是机会，只是路漫长。我觉得，如果我说的是如果可以的话，要考一个本科，然后好好学医院，不管怎么样都坚持下来，总有一天。我相信我自己，总有一天我会成功的。
哦，参与，
王贵家本来也是住在我们三组，我们三组的地理环境也好，位置也好，在三个组里面，他们那里是交通最便利的，和外面接触也是最多的。目前那个三组的老百姓送小孩出去读书的也是最多的。
You could see the very connected relationship between the infrastructure and that open-mindedness or the willingness to accept new concepts, such as education.
就我们了解下来，他很有可能会成为我们村第一个上大学的。
China shifted focus on sustainable poverty alleviation, which means instead of giving people fish, you teach them how to fish. But then to teach them how to fish, you need to build infrastructure, you need to build these facilities, you need to give them education. And I think that's the true essence of the poverty alleviation team's job.
放电影，不仅让孩子看一下外面世界是什么样子，他们的父母也可以看一下外面世界是什么样子。我告诉他，如果你想让你的孩子以后到大城市去，对吧，过好的生活啊，买上小轿车，你就要让你的孩子读书。我讲的道理已经很简单了，我说一千次一万次了，总有几个家长会听，会在脑海里面他会反思，我是应该让孩子读书。
路上注意车，好不好？
好。
因为他们舍不得坐客车，客车得15块钱，然后大人都舍不得，所以说小孩子更舍不得。
千万不要，我就发现你们没在学校，我又来找你们，听见没有？
听到了。
昨天我跟你们讲了，读书好不好？坐在教室里好好听课，
你好好学习啊，继续读书，可以吗？
可以吗？
好。
你们都是我们魁九村的希望，好不好？
好。我很幸福认识你们，我希望。我知道他们的生活有困难，但是因为有你们，他们的未来我希望会更好。我希望你们尽快达到你们的目标，非常谢谢你们。
I don't think that anyone is under the illusion that 2020 is the end game for.Poverty alleviation in China. If anything, right now, they're planting the seeds of change with a little bit of help in terms of infrastructure. And it's these seeds that are going to make the real change in the years to come.
He 现在我们要做的就是以前是要他脱贫，现在是我要脱贫，然后后面到乡村振兴一样的，他要致富。不是我们要他怎么样了，是他自己要有这个想法。
现在我们来了，我们相当于是带了一种火，哎，也不是火种嘛，就是一种方向嘛，能让他们觉得，哎，朝这个方向走，自己的日子会越来越好。
再见了，再见了。